Man, amen, amen, amen. Megan, are you on the line?
Yes, Pastor, I am. Thank you.
Awesome, awesome. The floor is yours.
Greetings in the name of Christ Jesus. We, the members of New Calvary Baptist Church, deem it a privilege to welcome each of you to our Mother's Day celebration. We lift our voices, making a joyful noise unto the Lord in thanksgiving for mothers everywhere. We cherish the courage, fortitude, and insight of mothers, evident when they have made a way out of no way.
Michael,
this day, we honor the women who gave us birth and non-biological mothers who daily nurture and pray for us. On behalf of the pastor, officers, and members of New Calvary Baptist Church, we welcome you. As we welcome each of you, we invite you to think on several things. Think of the gift of life mothers bring to us all. Think of those adoptive, biological, extended family, and foster care mothers who teach us our prayers, wipe dirty noses, help with school projects, plan birthday parties, work inside and or outside the home. We welcome you to join us in recognizing the mothers of the church, the Black mothers of history who have had the dreams and have offered prayers that brought many of us out of the depths of despair, out of harm's way. We honor those who have taught us that we are special, that we are somebody. Welcome to our church home. Welcome to our hearts. Welcome to all mothers and all mothers' children. Welcome. Loving God, we ask you to bless all mothers today. May they feel the joys of motherhood every day. In all their struggle, giving us livelihood, may your love and compassion be with them for good. May every mother feel today the pride and beauty of the family they bear. Through all pain and sorrow, Lord, deliver them. In your strength and grace, may they always stay. Amen.
Amen. And good morning, everyone. Now we will have our responsive reading. This day we celebrate the call of motherhood as a ministry of commitment to God and to God's people. We honor those mothers, living and dead, who have loved the children of the world. Let not the hearts of mothers be troubled, divine creator. Teach us to be mothers who love, but not to love so much that we lose all balance and perspective in dealing with our families. All together, may each of us be parent or child, wherever we can love each other. Let us extend our families to include those in need. May we bless others and ourselves as we honor mothers and as mothers honor us.
Now we have a prayer by Deacon Monica Moore Smith.
Good morning. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Okay, good morning. Let us pray. Father, we come before you in humility, asking, oh God, that you examine our hearts today. Father God, thank you for waking us up this morning in our right minds. Father God, we thank you for your grace, oh Lord, that is sufficient today and forever. Father God, we thank you for your mercy that is great. Lord, thank you for being our rock and redeemer. Father God, thank you for being our shield and our strong tower. Father, we come, oh God, to lift you up and praise your holy name this morning. Lord, you're holy. Lord, you are great. Lord, you've been better than good to us. Thank you, Lord. Lord, you have made a way for us time after time. Thank you. Lord, so many times you have healed us. We thank you. Father, thank you for reminding us that your word never changes. Lord, you're awesome, even in such a time as this. You have kept, oh God, our mind stayed on you. Thank you for keeping us from all of the distractions, oh Lord, all of the pain, all of the loss, and all of the worry, Lord, we have experienced through this pandemic and this time. Father, thank you for reminding us to choose faith, oh God, over fear in our lives. Because you, your word says, oh God, there is no fear in love. Your word says, oh God, do not be afraid. I am with you. Thank you, Lord. Father, thank you for your everlasting love toward us. Father God, thank you for New Calvary Baptist Church. Father God, we thank you for our pastor, Pastor J.T. Thomas, and First Lady Angela. Father, I pray, oh God, an anointing over Pastor Thomas, and that you will keep him and his family in your arms of care and love. Father God, I pray an anointing over all the ministers, the deacons, and trustees. Father, I pray your light will shine through us, oh God, that someone will see and feel your presence. Father God, I just pray that we can be a light to someone in need. Father, I pray for all of our church members, family, and friends who have joined us this morning online and by phone. Lord, thank you for all of the mothers this morning. Lord, we thank you for them. Lord, we just pray that you will rain down a sweet spirit of love and joy and happiness and peace over them this day, for they are worthy, oh God. Father, we thank you, God, right now, and just ask that you will allow us to feel your presence. Come, oh Lord, right now. Father God, we praise you, we worship you, we adore you, and we love you. Lord, it is in the name of Jesus that we do pray. Let everyone say amen.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory.
Amen. Unmute yourselves and give God a good amen, a good hallelujah. Thank you so much, Reverend Moore.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Wonderful singing, wonderful prayer.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. That's right. Thank you.
All right. Good day, New Calvary. It is time for our announcements, and I'm going to go ahead and read those. Our announcements for today, next Sunday's church school lesson is Practice Justice, and that's based on the scripture reading from Jeremiah 21, verses 8 through 14. Again, that's scripture Jeremiah 21, verses 8 through 14 on Practice Justice. Other announcements, Meals for Seniors. The Detroit Area Agency on Aging, DAAA, is providing frozen meals for seniors ages 60 and up. Seniors can pick up 5 days worth of meals every Wednesday from 11:30 a.m. to 1 p.m. at the following recreation centers: Butzel Family Center at 7737 Kirchival in Detroit, Farwell Recreation Center at 2711 Outer Drive East in Detroit, Patton Community Center, 2301 Woodmere Street in Detroit, and Joseph Walker Williams Center at 8431 Rosa Parks Boulevard in Detroit. Financial assistance is available through the Wayne County Metro. Wayne County Metro is helping the community through its CARES Relief and Recovery Program. They will pay rent, mortgage, DTE bills, City of Detroit water bills, provide food and diapers, and up to $1,500 in funeral costs. There are other items that can be provided as well. Some items you must show notice of shutoff or an eviction letter to qualify for certain funding. For more information, you can contact Wayne Metro at 313-977. I'm sorry, I don't have all of the number. I will get that back to you in a moment. But you can also contact them at https://waynecountymetro.org/cares. The U.S. Census Bureau mailed out the 2020 census questionnaire to households nationwide. It's absolutely critical that the census is completed. I know many of you may say I sound like a broken record, but it is essential. Tomorrow is not promised. I'm sure most of you have completed your census forms, but if not, you are encouraged to do so immediately. There are three ways to respond. You can respond online at https://my2020census.gov, by telephone at 1-800-354-7271, or by mail. You can also, we're inviting everyone to participate in the New Calvary Baptist Church check-in. And that check-in will take place this Thursday at 6 p.m. You'll use the same Google Meet online access or the dial-in number that you use for today's service. Everyone is also invited to subscribe to New Calvary Baptist Church YouTube page, and you can go to YouTube to subscribe to that. Today, we are recognizing and celebrating our youth, and who did an amazing job leading the prayer conference this week. So we'd like to thank all of those who participated. Also, we would like to graduate one of our youth, Megan Driver, on continuing her scholastic achievement education. She will be attending Tennessee State University. Congratulations, Megan. And then we have celebrating a birthday today is Sister Janice Washington. So happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to all of those who have a birthday coming up this week. And if you'll give me just a moment here, I'm going to give you that phone number for Wayne Metro. So just bear with me. I thought I had the entire number on the list, but I didn't.
I put it in chat, Bridget.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. That number for Metro Wayne Financial Assistance is 313-388-9799. Okay, if there are no other announcements, I think at this point, I would like to once again, as Megan did earlier, wish happy birthday to all of those who serve as mothers, whether you have biological children or not. And I'd like to welcome all our New Calvary members and all our many guests who are in attendance today. We are so happy that you chose to take the time out to worship with us. And so we will take like the next 2 or 3 minutes just to fellowship. So please unmute your calls and just extend a good day to all your fellow worshipers.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Happy Mother's Day, everybody.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day,
my Lisa.
Hi, Deborah. Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day, everybody.
Happy Mother's Day, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning. Happy Mother's Day. Good morning. Happy Mother's Day, everyone.
Mother's Day.
Thomas. How's everybody? Have a blessed day. This is Regina.
Thank you.
Janine. God bless you.
Okay. Good morning, Saints. How are you? This is Dee, and it is my privilege to share the altar call prayer here at home. Won't you pray with me? Dear God, our Father, we touch and agree with the prayers that have already gone up. We thank you for New Calvary and our leadership. We thank you, God, for another day to praise you, to worship you, to bless your holy name. We ask your blessings upon every church that's open in your name, that your word would go out, Lord, that lives might be saved. Today, we come with a special prayer for mothers, mothers everywhere. We especially pray for the mothers who birthed us, our godmothers, our grandmothers, those who wiped our nose, who fixed the food, who encouraged us, Lord, when no one else would. We just thank you for them. We realize, God, that given this season of COVID-19, some are suffering from bereavement. Some were not able to even say goodbye to their moms. But Lord, we thank you that there's a morning after, that we will see them again. And we pray that cherished memories will comfort and keep them during these difficult times. We pray, Father, for all the surrogate moms, the aunties, the sisters in the church who baked the pies, who did the fish dinners, who patted us on our head, who encouraged us, Lord, with the little speeches. Lord, we thank you, God, for neighbors and for friends. We thank you for adopted moms. Not everybody, Lord, for one reason or another, could be a biological mom. And so we just thank you for those who stepped up, Lord, who were there when we needed them. We pray that you'll continue to bless them. Father, we know that every mother-child relationship was not a good one. And so we pray, Father, that you bless those children. Some of us long grown. I had a wonderful mother, but we pray, Father, for those who had those strained relationships, that they'll find peace, that they will find forgiveness in their heart. Lord, we pray that they will understand that through your providential hand, Lord, that mother was allowed to bring life, their life, into this world. And so we pray, Father, that they are comforted knowing that you love them. We pray, Father, for women who want to be moms. Oh, this is such a tough part. Lord, we remember Hannah, how she prayed out for a child. There are some suffering amongst us, friends and family, who are really struggling because they can't have a biological child, or they've had one and it's been a miscarriage. Lord, we pray that you will comfort them like no one else can, that you will be with them, Lord, that your blessings will shower them, that they will have the peace of Hannah. And Lord, if it's your will, they will be blessed with a child, knowing, oh God, that child doesn't have to come from them biologically, but they can reach out and be a blessing at any time. We thank you for just the spirit of moms, the way you have formed and shaped women. Lord, some of us are Titus women now, but all of us have that loving, caring heart, Lord. We think of Mary at the cross. We don't know where Joseph was, but Lord, mamas, they show up. And again, biological or those who just were placed in our lives by you. And so we thank you for them. Finally, Father, we thank you for Jesus. We thank you for the blood that was shed. You loved us before we loved ourselves. And so, Father, we give you glory. We give you honor. We thank you for sending the Holy Spirit to comfort us, to keep us, to guide us, to be all the things and more that a mother can be. This morning, Father, we pray that you bless the rest of our service, that we will go, Lord, we will hear the word, that we will take it into our hearts, that it won't be just words, but Lord, we will gain something from it that we can take throughout the rest of the week. Finally, Father, we pray that you will bless our governments. Amidst COVID-19, so many states are opening up. We pray that you will grant balance, that you will give them wisdom and knowledge to know how to proceed. Lord, bless our people, that we won't step into harm's way unknowingly, but that we will prepare as best we can, knowing, oh God, that you cover us. It's been you all along, Lord. We pray, Father, that you continue to be with healthcare workers, those on the front lines, the policemen, the firemen, the doctors and nurses. We pray that you be with the grocery store clerks and all of those returning to plants. We just can't stop thanking you, Father, for who you are, what you've done, what you are currently doing, and what you're going to do. We just wait with the wonderful expectation, Father. We give you the glory and the honor because it's yours. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Unmute yourselves and say amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
Amen. Thank you so much, Reverend Key, for that timely and appropriate prayer for the day for all mothers across America, especially the mothers here at New Calvary. It is at this moment that we worship God in giving, for giving is worship and worship is giving. We here at New Calvary, we have a multiplicity of methods to give. Certainly, you can continue the traditional manner in which you give. You fill out completely your tithes and offering envelope, and you can drop them off in the mailbox, or you can drop them off at the mail slot here at the church. We are going to update our mail slot so that we can make sure that you feel secure in giving. So right now we ask that you drop them off in the mailbox, and certainly our trustees here at New Calvary will make sure that you are accounted for in your giving. The other methods we have to give is we just simply ask you go to our church website, newcalvarybaptist.org. And then there's a box that's, I believe it's blue, right on the face of our website. It says Give Online. You can click that box, and then it takes you directly to the methodology on how to give. You can also download our Simple Give app on your Android or iPhone device and worship God in your giving. You can't beat God giving no matter what you do. Each and every day, God gives us life. He gives us health. Most of all, he grants us strength. And so we cannot give back to God all that he has blessed us with, but certainly we can let the Lord know that not only is he Lord over our lives, but he's also Lord over our pocketbooks. The giving that you provide for New Calvary keeps our ministries going, keeps our building going. I'm just excited, and I'm just in awe of the reports that I get each and every week from our trustees on how the members of New Calvary have stepped up to the plate, and they have made it known that not only do they worship God in singing, worship God in praying, but we worship God in our giving. Congratulations, New Calvary. We are just honored that you have stepped up to the plate, met your financial commitments, and you continue to give. In our giving, we like to make a tithes and offering affirmation to God. This is not a conversation that you have with me or with the trustees or with the deacons, but this is an affirmation that you make to God. And so I ask at this time, as I say my portion, You gather around your family and friends or those you are in close contact with at your place of residence, and you say your part. This is an affirmation. This is a promise. This is a commitment to God that we let him know that he is first and foremost in our giving. And it says, as we prepare to give, as God has given unto us,
service must be over.
This sacrifice unto the Lord. With a cheerful heart and an attitude of gratitude, we bring this sacrifice unto the Lord. To whom do we give? God, who made the world and all things therein. Why do we give? The earth is the Lord's, and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. What shall we give unto the Lord for all God's benefits toward us? I will not offer unto the Lord that which will cost me nothing. What commandment does the Lord make to us in giving? Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse. What promise does the Lord make to us in giving? Altogether, see if I will not open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing. You will not have room enough to receive. Would you join with me in a word of prayer? Our Father and our God, we thank you. We love you. We praise you. And most of all, we adore you. And we thank you, God, that you have placed us in a position to give of our time, our talent, our treasure, as well as our testimony. Lord, we pray that the giving that we are participating in be used for the upkeep of your church and your kingdom. It's in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we ask all things. Let everyone say amen and amen. We have on the line Sister Erica Hayes, who is going to lead us in a song of reflection. I'm just excited that she's going to worship with us in her song and in the gift that God has blessed her with. And then afterwards, the next message you will hear will be from me, your pastor, sharing a recorded message that God has blessed me to participate in this time. Erica, are you on the line?
Yes.
All right. The floor is yours.
Nice picture there. Thanks, Pastor.
All righty. I'm ready.
He is jealous for me, loves like a hurricane. I am a tree bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me. And oh, how he loves us. Oh, oh, how he loves us. How he loves us. Oh. He is jealous for me, loves like a hurricane. I am a tree bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I'm unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me. Oh, how he loves us so. Oh, how he loves us. How he loves us. Oh, ooh.
Amen. Unmute yourselves and say amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen,
Erica.
Thank you.
Amen.
Feel it.
Amen. Amen.
Feel it.
Praise God.
Amen.
Praise
thank you,
God.
Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
Amen.
Real good.
Good morning. Good morning, New Calvary. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. I'm so glad that you took the opportunity to all of our family and friends of New Calvary to join with us on this glorious Sunday morning, May 10th, 2020. Happy Mother's Day. To all of the mothers who are listening and joining with us here at New Calvary. We are just honored, despite the pandemic crisis that we are in, you made a conscious decision to join with us here at New Calvary, as not only we celebrate all of the mothers on Mother's Day, but we celebrate our risen Savior, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We do this every Sunday, regardless of the externalities that are going on, the crisis that exists in our world. God has allowed our church to utilize technology to come together and in fellowship, but also to worship him in spirit and in truth. It is at this time that we come together to hear what thus saith the Lord. We've heard the songs that are sung, the prayers that are prayed, but we need to hear from God, not only on this great day as we celebrate the mothers of New Calvary and all the mothers who are listening, but we want to hear what God is saying to us in such a time as this. So I want to invite you to join with me with a passage of scripture that's familiar with all of us, the Gospel according to St. John, John chapter 14, beginning at verse number 1 and ending at verse number 14. The gospel according to St. John. The Bible's broken up into two halves, the old and the new. The Old Testament has 39 books in the Old Testament, beginning with Genesis and ending with Malachi. The New Testament has 27 books, beginning with Matthew and ending with the book of Revelation. The first portion or segment of the New Testament is called the Gospels. The first three books of the Gospels are entitled the Synoptic Gospels. But the Gospel that we're going to peruse in, the pericope of Scripture, is found in the Gospel according to St. John, John chapter 14, beginning at verse number 1 and ending at verse number 14. I'm going to read it nice and loud. I'll be reading from the New International Version, which should be similar to what you have. And then we'll open up with a word of prayer. Just for a few minutes, we'll have a conversation on this text. Okay. John chapter 14, beginning at verse number 1 and ending at verse number 14. And it reads as follows. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I'm going there to prepare a place for you. If I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. Verse 5 reads, Thomas said to him, Lord, we don't know where you are going. So how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really knew me, you would know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip said, Lord, show us the Father. That will be enough for us. Verse 9 reads, Jesus answered, don't you know me, Philip? Even after I have been among you such a long time, anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Don't you believe that I am in the Father and that the Father is in me? Words I say to you are not just my own. Rather, it is the Father living in me who is doing his work. Verse 11 reads, believe me when I say that I am in the Father and the Father is in me, or at least believe on the evidence of the miracles themselves. I tell you the truth. Anyone who has faith in me will do what I have been doing. He will do even greater things than these because I am going to the Father. And I will do whatever you ask in my name so that the Son may bring glory to the Father. You may ask me for anything in my name and I will do it. I want to emphasize verse number 13 as well as verse number 14, and I'll read it again. And I will do whatever you ask in my name so that the Son may bring glory to the Father. You may ask me for anything in my name, and I will do it. The word of God for the people of God to the glory of God. Would you join with me in a word of prayer? Father, we need to hear from you. We need a word from you. If we don't hear from you, Lord, what will we do? Longing for you more each day. Lord, show us your perfect way that we can live. Our Father and our God, We thank you. We love you. We praise you. And most of all, we adore you. We come here today on this glorious Sunday morning, on Mother's Day, first of all, lift up and praise, glory and magnify your holy name. Because, Lord, your name is so worthy to be praised. It is your name, Lord, that we call on. It is your name that we lift up in such a time as this. And so, Lord, I ask that you empty me and fill me with your spirit so that I may preach and teach your word with boldness. Lord, touch the waiting congregation, those that are listening from near and far, at the edge of their seat, crying and asking the question, what must I do to be saved? We pray, Lord, that it is this message that makes the comfortable uncomfortable. Lord, we lift up your name in such a time as this. In your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, we ask all things. Let everyone say amen and amen. I want to, for a few minutes, to have a conversation with you on this wise. There's power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. I could imagine that many of us, as we navigate through this pandemic crisis and we're going through the challenges that exist in our lives, many of us are going through challenges like separation from jobs. Many of us are going through challenges with a paradigm shift in our income. Many of us are suffering through challenges of isolation, challenges of doubt, and fear of the future. Many of us are just going through challenges and issues that we never thought that we would ever have to face in our lives. We never imagined that a city like the city of Detroit as well, or cities that you are listening from, would go from the hustle and bustle and commerce, active, moving, transitions, and all of the restaurants and sports and entertainment centers and all of these activities of luxury that we experienced before this pandemic crisis. And all of a sudden, our lives, our way of living, our decisions, our choices have come to a screeching halt. This screeching halt with no clear picture as to when we'll ever restart again. It almost seems like whenever we get close to the point where it seems like we're going to start again, we're tripped up. Things are rescheduled. The needle is moved farther and farther away, and we find ourselves asking the question that Philip is asking in this text. God, show us. Jesus, show us the Father. In 2020, as we look at the question that Philip is asking, we can update it to right now and ask the question, God, where are you? God, where are you? Where were you when this pandemic not only hit the city of Detroit, not only hit the state of Michigan, not only hit the Midwest, not only hit the United States, but this pandemic crisis has hit the entire world. God, where are you? Why does it seem like your presence is silent? God, where are you when I lost friends and family? God, where were you when I lost my job? Where were you, Lord, when our income was not only cut in half, but that half was cut? God, where are you? We find ourselves contemplating, wrestling. We find ourselves in a mode of ambiguity, trying to understand, God, where exactly have you been? Seems like you find comfort in our discomfort because your silence is so deafening. God, where are you? Philip asks that question. What prompted Philip to ask the question is that at the point, in the context of this particular pericope of scripture, the disciples are gathered together. And they know something is going on. Something is about to happen. Something is about to cause a change that they thought that they were prepared for, but all of a sudden they find out that that was just fluff. They find out that the one that they have followed, the one that called them by their name, is about to leave them. All of the preconceived notions that they had about this man called Jesus was going to not only restore the Jews into their rightful place, but he had even enough unction about himself to speak boldly in the face of those that wanted to see him die. They were concerned because it seemed like they walked with Jesus through chapter one of him changing water to wine. They walked with Jesus through chapter two of him spitting on the ground and making clay with his hands and giving sight to the blind. They walked with him through all of these chapters of his life, seeing those that came from near and far simply because they heard that he was near. They heard that he was near, and if they could just get near to this man called Jesus, all of a sudden they could be transitioned from the trials and tribulations and illnesses that they faced. They could all of a sudden be healed. But now, as all of the disciples are walking with Jesus through these chapters of his life, it seems like that they're getting mighty close to the end of this chapter, and they're perplexed, they are confused, they are worried, because they are about to experience a life-changing event that's going to take them outside of their comfort zone. And so Jesus, anticipating the angst and the worry that's existing in their life, he brings them all together. And he says to them with no hesitation, don't let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. Jesus, in essence, says, don't worry, don't get your hair in a ruffle. Take a chill pill. Don't allow what you are experiencing, what you're seeing right now to cause you to think that God is not there. And that's as he's saying, God is there because I am here with you. That's a word for someone on today. You may be worried and perplexed about what's going on in your social location, in your circle, but don't worry, God is there. And because you recognize that God is there, every now and then you've got to call on his name. There are names that you can call on that has some power. There are names that you can call on that has a little power, but there is a name above all names, that you can call on regardless of what you're going through, regardless of the time of day, regardless of the existential realities that you face. If you just call on that name that has all power behind it, that name that doesn't have an expiration date, that name that we call on even in the midnight hour. You can call on that name. But Jesus says in the text, he opens up in chapter 14, he says, do not let your hearts be troubled. If you believe in God, that same trust that you have in God is the same trust you can have in me. And he says, he moves on further and he says, not only can you trust in me, but you can trust that there, if there's a reservation made, I'll hold on to that reservation. Doesn't it hurt? Doesn't it make you upset when you call and you make reservations for a hotel or make reservations for a plane flight or make reservations for to dine at a restaurant, you make them maybe 6 or maybe 2 weeks in advance, and you get close to the point where the reservation becomes sure, only to find out that they did not keep that reservation. Jesus is saying not only to the disciples, but he's saying also to us, even today, as we navigate on May 10th, 2020, that I'll keep the reservation. You can trust in me. The reservation that he has, if ever something were to happen to you, is not a reservation for Days Inn. It's not a reservation for Motel 6, but this is a reservation in glory to be with the Father. It says, I go to prepare a place for you, and if I come back, I will take you with me, that where I am, you will be there also. Thomas, you know, asked the question. He says, God, we don't know exactly where you're going. And because we don't know where you're going, how can we know the way? And I could just imagine Jesus saying to him, wait a minute now, Thomas. If I'm telling you I go to prepare a place for you, and if I say I'm coming back to receive you unto myself, I'm going to show you, I'm going to take you along the way. That's encouraging for somebody here today. You thought that you were all by yourself. You thought that just because family and friends are with you, you still felt like you were isolated. But I've got good news for you today. You can rest assured that Jesus is with you. And the text says that Jesus will take us to the Father. That's my first point. Y'all just missed that. Let me say that one more again. Jesus will take us to the Father. We have a home that's prepared for us, and the only way we can get there is through the Son. Let me paint the picture of an illustration so I can make sure that you understand point number one before we go to point number two. Jesus takes us to the Father. There was a story about a young boy who was in a classroom about eighth graders in a grade school session. The class made plans to take a trip to the White House. A class of about 15 students, they all, you know, with their teacher, they said to themselves, you know what, we're going to take a trip to the White House. They were only about 2 hours outside of the White House. They got on their school bus and they all sat in their designated places, and they took that 2-hour trip to the White House. All 15 of them, including the teacher, was along with them and the bus driver. They drove from Philadelphia and then drove all the way to the White House. This was before 45. I'm talking about during the time of 44, because, you know, don't nobody want to go to the White House right now. But when Obama, the first Black president of the United States, was in the White House, there was a classroom from the city of Philadelphia, about 15 of them with, you know, that one teacher made 16 and the bus driver made 17, made that about a 2-hour trip from Philadelphia to Washington, D.C. They got off of the boat as because they were really excited about seeing the president of the United States. There was a young lad that was in the midst of the 15 named Tommy. You know, Tommy, he was, you know, a little disruptive in the classroom, a little, you know, rambunctious in the classroom. They were supposed to all be together, all 15 of them, but somehow, some way, they went through the outside gates. They were together. They went through the inner parts of the gates, and all 15 were together. But as soon as they got to the front door of where the White House was, somehow, little Tommy got separated from the pack. Little Tommy got lost from the pack. All 14 of them got inside the White House, but little Tommy ended up in the backyard of the White House. Little Tommy was worried. Little Tommy was perplexed. He said to himself, I've gotten on this school bus and traveled with all 15, but all of a sudden I find myself separated and I'm here lollygagging in the backyard of the White House. I don't know what to do. I'm crying. I'm perplexed. I hope the Secret Service don't put me out. Then all of a sudden a young girl tapped him on the shoulder. A young pretty girl tapped him on the shoulder and said, little boy, are you lost? Little boy, why aren't you with the other pack? He said, my attention got swayed and I find myself separated from the pack. And if there's any kind of way that I could at least get back with the other 14, that I could finally see the president of the United States, the first black president of the United States. The young girl, she had a little gleam in her eye. The young girl had a smile on her face, and she said, oh, don't worry about it. That president that you want to see, that first black president that you want to see, you'll never believe this, but that president is my daddy. And although you have been separated from the pack, I could take you directly to the president. Y'all just missed that because y'all think I'm talking about the president, but I'm talking about sometimes in our lives, we get separated from the pack and we find ourselves all alone, wondering how can we see the Father. But thanks be to God, the Son, the daughter, someone connected to the Father can overcome all of the gates, can overcome secret security and take us right to the Father. The text lets us know that Jesus can take us directly to the Father. That's point number one. Point number two, verses 7 through 11 reminds us. Point number one is Jesus takes us to the Father. Point number two, Jesus reveals the Father to us. You know, Jesus did a lot of things that reminds us of Jehovah Jireh. Jesus does or did a lot of things that reminds us of God, our provider. Jesus did a lot of things that reminds us of a God that delivers, a God that saves, a God that has all power in his hands. As a matter of fact, if you really are honest with ourselves, Jesus is just a chip off the old block. Let me prove that to you. Jesus got hands like his daddy. For we read in Genesis how the creator, the sustainer of life, the one that separated water from land, he also gathered up dust in his hands. And the text says he smoothed out and formed man with the palm of his hand. Jesus has his daddy's hands, because I remember there was a time when there was a man who was blind, and Jesus spit in the ground and with his hands picked up the dirt, made clay, and touched the man's eyes. Jesus got his daddy's hands. Jesus also has his daddy's heart. We recognize as the children of Israel navigated from being in captivity in Egypt and found themselves wandering in the wilderness for years and years, found themselves questioning and wondering whether or not they should have made this trip But the God of Israel, the God that rained manna from heaven, the God that watched over them, protected them, and the God that preserved them was the God that also forgave them. Jesus has his Father's heart, because the same heart that forgave the children of Israel is the same heart that was nailed to a hill called Golgotha. He was crucified on a cross, a wooden cross. They nailed him to a cross. They put a crown of thorns on his head, and he said with no hesitation, with the same heart of his daddy, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." Jesus reveals the Father because he got his Father's hands and he got his Father's heart. But I want to circle in as we close on verse number 13 and verse number 14, because I want to make sure that you understand that there's power in the name of Jesus. The text says in verse number 13 and verse number 13, "And I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Son may bring glory to the Father. You may ask me for anything in my name, and I will do it." You ever find yourself in a calamity or a rough spot or a tough situation, and every now and then you find yourself calling on the name of Jesus? You're never real specific on the situation, but you just say, "Jesus." You know, when you find yourself in a car about to experience a car wreck, and all of a sudden you don't necessarily say, God protect me, God maneuver the car so that it won't hit somebody else, but you just give the short version. You just say, "Jesus." Have you ever been in a situation where you don't know where your children are, and you really want to pray a long prayer and say, "God, I need you to not only bring my children home, but I need you to protect them on the way"? But you just cry out the name Jesus. You ever been in a situation in your life where you have more months than money, and you really want to pray a long prayer and say, "God, somehow would you contact Chase Bank and make that negative balance go to a positive balance, so that I could have a positive balance to pay some of these bills and some of these situations that's going on in my life"? But because the situation is so dire, you can't really go into a long discussion, but all you can do is just cry out the name Jesus. Let me let you know on today, when you cry out the name Jesus, all you're really doing is just name dropping. Oh, y'all just missed that. Let me say that one more again for those that are in the back room. When you call out the name Jesus, regardless of what's going on around you, all you're really doing is just name dropping. Somebody say hallelujah. Name dropping means it's a seemingly casual mention of prominent persons or associations done to impress others. Let me say that one more again. It is a casual mention of prominent persons or associates done to impress others. Now, I don't know about the casual mention, but I do know that when I'm faced with trials and tribulations in my life, that is not a casual mention, but I'm in a dire need. That's not a casual mention, but I'm in a serious situation. But I can also co-sign on the fact that it may not be a casual mention, but I'm calling on a prominent person. I'm calling on somebody who has all power in his hands. I'm calling on somebody who can heal me and who can deliver me whatever situations or trials that I'm in. But let me tell you something. It's not a casual mention, but I'm calling on a prominent person. But check this, I'm doing it so that I can impress others. Yo, ooh, yo, don't get too deep on me right now. Because see, when I'm trying to impress others, I'm trying to let folks know that this ain't me that healed me. This ain't me that delivered me. This ain't me that saved me. But this, I'm calling on somebody who has all power in his hands, and I'm connected to him, and I'm just trying to let you know and let you be impressed, not by me, but by the power of God. And you are not only impressed by the power of God, but you impressed that somebody, a wretch like me, is got the eye and the attention of the Lord. So as I close on this Mother's Day celebration, would you mind if I just name drop on who Jesus really is to me? And I'm just going to walk down the ABCs. A, our God is almighty. B, he is the beginning and the end. C, he is the Christ. I'm just name dropping. D, he is a deliverer. E, he is the Elohim. F, he is my friend. G, he is the great I am. H, he is the Holy One. I, he is the I am. I'm just name dropping. J, he is the Jehovah. K, he is the King of Kings. L, he is love. M, he is the Messiah. I'm just name dropping. N, he is that Nazarene. O, he is the omnipotent God. P, he is my protector. I'm just name dropping. Q, he is that quickening spirit. R, he is the righteous one. S, he is the Savior. I'm just name dropping. T, he is the truth. U, he is the universal redeemer. V, he is victory. I'm just name dropping. W, he is wonderful. X, he has X-ray vision, because when those judge me on the outside, he knows what's going on the inside. I'm just name dropping. Why? He is Yahweh. And I couldn't really think of nothing for Z, but let me drop this in your spirit. He is my A all the way to Z. Y'all praise this holy name. We worship a God that has all power in his hands. He's Alpha and the Omega. He's the beginning and the end. He is my bright and morning star. I'm just name dropping. He's bread when I'm hungry. He's water when I'm thirsty. I'm just name dropping. I don't know who he is to you, but I know who he is to me. And when I call on his name, the Bible says, I ask anything in his name, and he will do it. And so on this particular Mother's Day celebration, I invite you to get to know that there's power in the name of Jesus. And whatever trial and situation you go through in your life, you can call on the name Jesus. Oh, I could just hear mothers across America calling on the name of Jesus. I could just hear fathers across America calling on the name Jesus, and they recognize that there's power in that name. There's power in the name of Jesus. Would you join with me in a word of prayer? Our Father, we thank you. We love you. We praise you. And most of all, we adore you. Lord, forgive us when we get to the point where we don't feel your presence. Forgive us, Lord, when we get to the point where we feel like you're not there. But like the songwriter said, you were there all the time, waiting patiently in life. You were there all of the time. Amen. We thank God for what our eyes have seen, what our ears have heard, but most of all, what our heart have felt. And we invite those that are listening, that are not connected to the name Jesus. We invite you to accept him into your heart, to your mind, and to your soul. You say with me, Father, I believe that your son, Jesus Christ, died on Calvary's cross for all of my sins. But I know the story did not end there, but he rose with all power in his hand. And when you accept him into your life, your heart, and you recognize that you are a sinner saved by grace, the text says you are saved. And I don't know about you, because I know that I'm saved. I accept that Jesus has a reservation in glory for me. Now, to those who are not connected to a healthy, well-balanced church, I invite you to join New Calvary Baptist Church, where we are a Christ-centered church of committed Christians connecting the community with the cross of Christ. Give us a call here at the church, 313-923-1600. Share with us your name, your information, and we'll share information with you. And we will connect with you and help you as you navigate learning more about a healthy relationship with God, with his son, and with this church. I thank all of you for taking the time to share with us on this Mother's Day celebration. And you may have heard this message, and you may have worshiped with us the entirety of this day, and you want to be a financial blessing to our ministry, go to our website, newcalvarybaptist.org, and click the give online button, and you can be a blessing to our church as we continue on this journey to step up our technology and make sure that the Word of God is being preached to the ends of the earth. I want to thank you. May God bless all of you. May God keep you is our prayer. Be blessed.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Pastor, for that word. Amen. You right on point Amen. With the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Yes. Yes.
Well, that can happen here in the office.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Jesus.
Thank you for the word, Pastor.
Yes, thank you
for the word.
Thank you.
I needed that.
Thank you for the word, Pastor.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes, Pastor.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Lord.
You know what to say today.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You know what to say today. Praise God. Praise God. Amen.
Yeah. Amen. Ooh, y'all should have saw me in the office. I'm ripping and running throughout the office.
Get somewhere and sit down.
Opportunity to... You're not by yourself.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen, Pastor.
Amen. Thank you. Amen. Thank you for taking the opportunity to share with us on this Mother's Day. Thank you for absorbing this word, and we pray that we take the word and allow it to be an active active living in our hearts and our minds, to just call on the name of Jesus, because there's power in his name. When you face trials, you don't have to go through a long dissertation or a long encyclopedia of words. Just say his name, and I believe in the power of his name. Amen. To all of our visitors and guests who came to worship with us on this morning from near and from far, we are excited that you became part of this celebratory Mother's Day celebration. To all the mothers, please make sure you celebrate on this day. Celebrate your mothers, whether she's here with you or gone on to glory. Rely on the memories and the words that she shared with us to help shape and mold us to who and what we are today. May God bless all of you, and may God keep you, is our prayer. Unmute yourselves and let's just fellowship as we close out.
Hallelujah. God bless you too, Pastor.
Happy Mother's Day, Myrina. Amen. Now to him who's able to keep us from falling and present us faultless before his presence with great joy. The only wise but God be glory, honor, dominion, and power now and forever. Let us all say amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen. Enjoy this week, guys.
Have a blessed one, everybody. Have a blessed one.
Have a good day.
Bye bye.
Good Lord. Thank you.
Happy Mother's Day, Ma.
That sound like Lenise.
Happy Mother's Day, everyone.
Keep it in.